Well, hey there. Look, welcome to day 1,288 of What She Up To Now. Sharon Horne-Ellstrom here, documenting the journey as I transition from the brick and mortar corporate world of business over a quarter century in corporate America, simultaneously working on my own businesses. So I've been in my own businesses, at least 27 different businesses and industries, offline over the last 47, probably closer to 48 years. And following my divorce, I had the opportunity, and it didn't always feel like an opportunity, but the opportunity to do something different, to ask myself, okay, my kids are grown up. I don't have to have them depending on me. What do I want to do? What have I always been curious about? And I had noticed the internet and the online world, but I hadn't really dug in or jumped in or paid attention. I was too busy doing things the old-fashioned way, the offline way, to really get involved with the online world. And so this was a huge opportunity, a huge chance for me to actually investigate, look into something that I'd always been curious about, and that was the online world. I mean, I grew up in corporate America before there were very many women in there, much less computers. I mean, yes, we had computers, but early days of software and computers, nothing like today, where every cell phone, everybody's walking around with more computer power than my university had when I was going to college. We actually used to learn on punch cards. I know, how scary is that? Punch cards. I think it's fascinating. I wonder if I still have one punch card in my box of memoirs or something from college. That would be funny, because most people can't even fathom that much technological change in such a short period of time. In the last 50 years, think of how much our lives have changed. We had up at the cabin an old rotary phone, and I know my nephew, who's 21 now, he and his friends were always fascinated by the rotary phone because they just they'd never seen one in their lives. So I think it's fun to think back on those technologies and see how far we've come. Some ways the world continues to get better, and in other ways it tends to get worse, but that's the nature of everything, right? There's a positive side and a negative side to everything. Just like each coin has two sides, every situation, everything has the upside, the downside, or just neutral, and it's up to us to decide what is most important. So today I'm thinking about making a fresh start, because that was our idiom for Supersize Your Business today. And I shared an 8-step process for making a fresh start that I found online, and then argued a little bit about a couple of the steps, because they're like, yeah, these are interesting steps. I can see how they would work, but they wouldn't be what I would use, or maybe they wouldn't be the order I'd use them in, but it doesn't matter. Everything we read and see and are exposed to, we can learn something from. So I learned a couple cool things by sharing that idiom and that expression today. Our tool for the Get Up and Go Challenge, day 9 of the free 30 plus day Get Up and Go Challenge today. This is our 8th time through and sharing the Get Up and Go Challenge. And every time it's a little bit different. It's similar, but I take the best of the previous challenge and I keep building on it, or we keep building on it and adding to it and making it better and better and better. And about the 4th challenge in, we started adding, we were sharing tools throughout the challenge, but I made it my mission to find out and figure out a way to add a tool every single day of the challenge, so to give people that might not have their own toolbox already established at least 30 plus tools to have to use to work in different areas and aspects of their life from this point forward. You know, one of the biggest things, if we pay attention to the people around us, we'll find, and maybe even in ourselves, it's a lot of people can't make a decision. A lot of people really struggle with making decisions. So I want to make sure that I incorporated some of the best decision-making tools that I've learned throughout my decades of life and experience into the challenge, so that now anybody that goes through the challenge, they don't just have one way to make decisions. They have at least 4 or 5 different decision-making tools that they can call on whenever they want. Now, these are some tools I've used in my life and with my family. I remember, like, nominal group technique. I taught that to my daughter when she was 8 years old. She won a puppy and she wanted to name her puppy, and she wasn't sure about the process to go about naming her puppy. So if my 8-year-old daughter can use a nominal group technique tool now, and she's got that tool, she's had that since she was 8, she's known how to do that, and she's used it time and time again to help her make complex decisions. Now you might say, well, is naming a puppy really a complex decision? It is to an 8-year-old. It took her 3 days and 3 pages of names, and the whole family helping her nominal group technique to come up with the name of, for her puppy. And she named her puppy Cola with a K. It was a black lab. So it just goes to show you that we can learn tools that help us help people and impact us for our entire lifespan, and by teaching them to other people. A lot of the tools and things that I use, I learned from my dad as a child growing up. One of my favorite decision-making tools I learned from my dad when I was probably, 5 or 6 years old. Yet, it is still my go-to decision-making tool today when I want to make a quick and simple decision, when it's not life or death. And guess what? If it is life or death, I'm going to use that one too, because it's quick and easy and I can make a decision and a choice. So make a fresh start, supersize your business, get up and go challenge was all about using a tool called Flip Switch. Today's was about Flip Switch. And I learned this one following my sudden cardiac arrest. I might have heard about it before, but I'd never heard it called the Flip Switch. And a friend of mine, Jim Edwards, who's an online genius, love Jim Edwards, and copywriting guy, he mentioned to me on the Gym Boat, which is a cruise that he does. It's a marketing training cruise. following my sudden cardiac arrest, because my goal was after that sudden cardiac arrest, I'd already planned on going that cruise. I was going on that cruise a couple months later. So I did. And on it, he's like, oh my God, we're so glad you're here, but have you read this book or have you done this workbook? Because we were talking about it. And I'm like, no, I haven't. And so as soon as, actually, while I was on the ship, I ordered it on Amazon. So it was at my house when I got home. It took me over a year to go through that workbook called Excuse Me, Your Life is Waiting. And then I started it again. I bought copies for my kids and I started the book again last year as part of this whole get up and go thing and COVID, and to give me something to do to focus and understand what's important to me now, because it had been about 10 years since I'd done it earlier. And I still haven't finished it. It's on my bed and I pick it up every couple of days and I'm making myself go in order through the exercises. And so I could make excuses, but I've committed to myself to go through it one exercise at a time and actually do it. And so it's taken me a while because it's that important to me. I think the most important thing we can do is to get to know ourselves and develop ourselves and continue moving in the directions and in the way that's important for us. And the tools that we need will come to us when we're open to and ready to use them, I guess. So I just want to expose people to some tools that can help them when they're ready. You might, you know, Lynn Grabhorn, you might not be ready for that book for another 20 years, but you might remember when something happens in your life that you really want to do some introspection and figure out yourself, you might remember and pick up that book and get it and do that workbook and say, oh yeah, I remember Sharon said something about this in 2021. Here it is, you know, 2039, and I'm just getting to it now. Anyway, our annual idiom this year, I am just off babysitting my granddaughter this weekend. Our annual challenge to do one thing every day that centers us was all about not staying on the sidelines, actually getting in the arena and participating in our life. So I love that, because it's easy to just sit on the sidelines and watch our lives go by, watch time go by, watch people do other things and think, oh, I wish I had done that. And then we have to ask ourselves, well, why didn't I do that? Why didn't I ever try that? Why didn't I ever write that book? Why didn't I ever say that? Why didn't I ever tell that person thank you? Why didn't I ever, you know, buy that dress, go on that cruise? Whatever it is for you, nothing worse than living with regrets, I think, and looking back and thinking, well, what if I had done that? What if I had made a different decision? What if I had made a different choice? Just because we stopped ourselves because we were afraid of something. And that's about the only thing that ever stops us, right? Is because we're afraid of something. All right, so supersize, annual challenge, get up and go challenge, babysitting my amazing 6-month-old granddaughter. I said she was 8 months old yesterday. That's how discombobulated I was yesterday. No sleep. A little more sleep last night. Not much, but a little more. Kids will be home in a couple of days, so that will be awesome. But I am having a great time. Nothing more amazing than snuggling up with a little cuddly boo. My daughter calls her the Nugget. She's a little nugget. She's just an amazing little spirit. She always wakes up smiling. Who doesn't love somebody that wakes up smiling every single day, every single nap, every single time? It's fantastic. So if I can help you with anything, hit me up in the comments below. Otherwise, get up and go challenge, working on that. Invite you to join us. Remember, I don't have disappearing content. So if you join the Get Up and Go Challenge private group, every challenge that we've done, plus all the supplemental material, it's all in there. You can search it. You can find any topic that you might want if you are interested in moving forward, making change and challenges automatic for you, making your life easier. Anybody want to make their life easier? I'm raising my hand because I always want to make my life easier. That's it. Have an awesome day. Any questions, I can help you in any way. Ask. Might be a little slow to respond. Hanging out with a six-month-old, but I promise I will get back to you. I might not know the answer, but I guarantee I can hook you up with the person or the resource or the thing to get you moving, keep you moving just to the next step. We only ever need to know the next step. You know, that saying, you don't have to see the whole staircase. You just have to know the next step. And as soon as you take that next step, the step after that appears. And you don't know that until you actually take some steps. Until you take a step, you won't believe that. But as soon as you take that step, it'll happen for you. And once it happens for you, you are a lifetime believer. All right. Have a great day. I will, of course, be with you tomorrow. Bye.